Hi everyone, in this video, we are going to demonstrate how to migrate DST shadow volume data to cloud storage. Before starting with DST migration procedure, let's see the prerequisites that needs to be taken care of. Ensure to salvage the required files available in the DST shadow volume, otherwise the files cannot be salvaged after the data is migrated to cloud. As a precaution, it's better to take a backup of the DST shadow volume before performing the DST migration. Ensure that all the active DST policies, that is policies scheduled for future and running DST policies, are completed or stopped. In OES Remote Manager, under Manage NCP Services, Manage Server tab, ensure to set the DST parameter information as follows. For more information on these parameters, see DST Administration Guide. So, what does this video cover? DST migration procedure includes 5 steps. First, we need to associate DST volume to CIS tier. Migrate DST shadow volume data to cloud storage. Remove the DST pair. Ensure that the DST primary, secondary, and cloud-backed volumes are mounted. And finally, switch the DST migrate tier to normal cloud tier. You need to perform these steps sequentially as shown. Go to OES server command line and check the pool status. DST_PRI_pool is the primary pool cluster resource. And DST_SEC_pool is the secondary pool cluster resource. Both the primary and secondary pool cluster resource are active. Similarly, check the volume status. PRI_VOL is the DST primary volume and SEC_VOL is the DST shadow volume. Both the DST primary and shadow volume are active and mounted. Now, check the cluster status. DST secondary pool cluster resource should be offline. Check the ncpcon status of DST primary volume. You can see the shadow mount point with DST shadow volume. Let's check the files available in both the DST primary and secondary volumes. Now, log in to CIS Management Console and create a DST TO. Go to Tiers, Migrate from DST tab, and click Add. Before starting with configuring TO, ensure to disable all the DST policies set. Also, ensure that the cloud account and policy is already configured. Under Server, I am selecting the cluster resource pool server where DST primary volume is available. Select the DST primary volume. I am selecting the cloud account configured for the DST migration. Specify the bucket name where the DST shadow volume data should be migrated. Select the region for the cloud account selected. And finally, select the schedule for the tier run. We have different options for scheduling the tier run. For demo purpose, I am selecting none so that I can trigger the migration manually. And then click Save. Go to Migrate from DST to view the DST tier created. In OES server command line, let's see the ncpcon status of volumes. We can see the stub volume or cloud-backed volume named PRI_VOL_CBV is created and mounted by default. Check the ncpcon status of cloud-backed volume. You can see the shadow mount point as null. Let's check the ncpcon status of primary volume. From shadow mount point, it says the DST pair still exists. Go to CIS Management Console, Migrate from DST tab, and start migration. Click Statistics, Latest Migration to view the status of the last scheduled run. The DST migration is completed. In OES server command line, let's do ls on cloud-backed volume. It lists all the stub information of migrated files. In OES server command line, check the cluster status. Offline the primary pool cluster resource. Go to ncpserve.conf file. Remove the shadow volume entry and save the file. Similarly, go to ncp2nss.conf file. Remove the secondary volume entry and save the file. Stop the eDirectory service. And then restart the eDirectory service again. Restart ncp2nss.service. Next, we need to modify the cluster scripts. Log in to iManager. Go to Roles and Tasks, Clusters, My Clusters tab. Select the cluster name, Primary Pool Cluster Resource, Scripts. Under Load Script, remove the DST secondary pool information. Click Apply and then click OK to save the changes. Similarly, go to Primary Pool Cluster Resource, Scripts, under Unload Script, remove the DST secondary pool information. Click Apply and then click OK to save the changes. In OES server command line, let's check the cluster status. For the changes to take effect, online the DST primary pool cluster resource and also online the DST secondary pool cluster resource. Verify the cluster status. Both primary and secondary cluster pool resources are online. Now check the pool status. Check the NSS volume state. The cloud-backed volume is deactive. Go to NSS MU and mount the cloud-backed volume. Now verify the status of cloud-backed volume. Check the ncpconf status of primary volume, secondary volume, and cloud-backed volumes. Ensure that the shadow mount point is null for all the volumes. In CIS Management Console, go to Tiers, Migrate from DST tab. Click Cloud icon under Actions. Select the required policy and click Migrate to switch the DST tier to normal cloud tier. Now, go to OES server command line and check the ncpconf status of primary volume. The CIS shadow mount point will be PRI_VOL_CBV, that is cloud backed volume. Go to CIS management console, tiers, migrate from DST tab. No DST tier is available. Now go to tier tab to view the cloud tier. For more information on DST migration to cloud, refer to Cloud Integrated Storage Administration Guide. Thanks for watching. Thank you.
Thank you.